Hello everyone, I am Gabriele, welcome to my channel. Today I play Hypsilophodon. Now, to be honest, it's not one of my favorites. It's an excellent playable because strategically speaking, if you are in a group, mixed packing, mixed herding, it's an excellent addition. With the blinding, with its blinding venom, it can actually decide the fate of a battle, of a skirmish. So let's say you are playing together with a Stegosaurus. The Stegosaurus is very goofy, very slow moving. And the Stegosaurus is versus Deinosuchus. So it's like a one versus one, very fair battle. Now, if the little creature, this Hypsilophodon, decides to spit on either the Stegosaurus or the Deinosuchus, for example, one of the two will surely lose because they cannot move, they cannot see where they are biting or using the tail whip, so it's gonna be like one side battle. Now, why it's not my favorite? Only because of this. Can you see the visuals? The visuals are very low. Now, I wouldn't have it any other way. This is a little playable, it's like small in size. There is no other way you should be able to play this type of playable because of its size. But anything smaller, in my opinion, would be unplayable. So Hypsilophodon is more one of the extremes. I don't know what's gonna be the huge extreme. This is the tiny extreme that we're gonna have in here. Now, this is the spit. You just press the right mouse button, you aim, and when you see the light over there, you just stop, nothing else. Can you see that? Now it's gonna be a little bit risky. I don't know if I can actually. Can you see it? And then you spit over there. No, I missed. That's kind of sad, but that's right. Every time that you spit, you waste some of your food. So you can get back that kind of food later on. Now you see that? I am very maneuverable. One of the perks of Hypsilophodon. Damage, I do not deal no damage. I mean, 15 newton is nothing as damage points that I can inflict. It's actually nothing. Now, the best type of gameplay for a Hypsilophodon is you get on a trunk, on a rock, on a higher level. You must have noticed, if you have played Hypsilophodon already a couple of times, you will actually jump after you release the jump button, after you release the space bar, that is. It's not like Utahraptor or Tenontosaurus, that you actually jump immediately as soon as you press the space bar. No, because of how tall you will jump, it depends on how long you will hold the space bar. So if you long for a long while the space bar, the taller, the higher your jump will be. So when you release the space bar, that's when your jump will actually happen, and the stamina depletion as well. Now, I wanted to try and blind one of them, if I can, that is. Yeah, I'm pretty bad. Now, every time that you spit venom, by the way, that is going to blind your enemy. Like this, from 62% I went to 47%. So you got a depletion of food of about 15%, kind of. 15% is kind of good. It's kind of good because I remember you that this is an herbivore, and it means that you can graze and get food back up to 20%. It means that you have infinite spits if you are by a grassland. So you just go back, you graze a bit up to your 20% of food of hunger, that is here down below on the right hand side. When this is again at 20%, you can use spit once, then you graze, you get it back at 20%, you can use spit again. Now, it's pretty powerful because it can decide the fate of a skirmish, of a battle, that is, depending on which size the little thing is on. Now, if you press the right mouse button and then you press the R button, you stop doing the spit. I mean, you keep press the right mouse button, and all of a sudden you decide, wait a moment, I do not want to deplete my food, my hunger. So you press R, the rocket R, Romeo letter on your keyboard, and it stops. Now, can I blind successfully that one? I think that is friendly, but I am a little fast, so I will actually blind you. Did I manage to blind you? Okay. I even beat that one, that peaceful giant. Okay. And now that peaceful giant is not peaceful anymore, the huge crocodile, actually. Okay, now, can I run, keep press the space bar, and then jump all of a sudden? Now, have you seen it? The space bar can also be held while you are running, so you can both press the running button and the jump button. And your stamina depletion or regeneration is actually pretty good. I mean, nothing else. And also, you are one of the best swimmer around. I mean, you are pretty fast and agile everywhere you go. Only downside is your bite and your life. You do not have life. I mean, you must have around 100 HP as a Hypsilophodon. 100, which is actually nothing. Correct me here, because it's an assumption I'm making. I haven't played Hypsilophodon that much. And the bite force, 15 Newton. Now, if you are good enough, you might be able to kill maybe a juvenile hatchling Euteraptor, a hatchling Carnotaurus, if you spit in their eyes and you start biting. But you still need to be careful, because they can take you down. The huge thing good about Hypsilophodon is that you can actually spit venom and blind other players. You blind and you decide a sort of a battle. Okay, the water here is pretty deep, so if there is any Deinosuchus, I would be dead by now. I wanna get... Oh, I'm not that good, as you can see. Oh, I can run and spit. Can I run and spit? Yes, I can indeed. And I'm dead. Well, that was all for today. If you are a good player with Hypsilophodon, you can actually be able to take down hatchlings and decide the sort of battles, thanks to the spit, to the venom, to the blinding mechanic that the Hypsilophodon has. Now, if any of you liked today's video, please put a like, subscribe, and decide to share it with everyone you know. Thank you all so much for watching, and I wish you a great day. Bye-bye.